What is going on, guys? It's Modded Warfare here. Welcome to episode 2 of Nintendo Switch Jailbreak Tutorials. This is the full series on how to get the most out of your jailbroken Nintendo Switch. In the first episode, we looked at how to actually jailbreak the Switch fully using free custom firmware. In this episode, we're going to be looking at how to install games. Now, as a disclaimer, I am not endorsing or encouraging piracy in this video. This is intended for backup purposes only, so please bear that in mind. So make sure you followed episode 1 if you haven't already. The playlist link will be in the description, and there'll also be a link at the end of the video to the playlist as well. So make sure you've watched episode 1 and you have everything set up to that point before heading on to this video. Installing games on free custom firmware has always been more complicated than on paid custom firmware, but it is doable and it's a lot easier than it used to be. We can install XCI file games, which I'm going to show you, also NSP file games, which are the two formats that Nintendo Switch games come in. They're either NSP, which are like eShop style games, that's that kind of format. And then there's the XCI file games, which are like a full game dump. And then we're also going to look at how to take a game that you have on game cartridge and dump that to the SD card so you can run it on the SD card without the game cartridge being inserted. It's very useful if you're somebody who travels and you don't like having to take all your games with you, because these little cartridges are easy to lose. So having them all on your SD card, which is inside your Switch, is just a much safer way to have all your games when you're traveling. Okay, so what we're gonna do first of all is I'm gonna show you how to dump a game on game cartridge to an XCI file. So we're gonna do that first. So the XCI file that I'm going to install is gonna be one that I dump from my game cartridge. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna insert my game cartridge, and don't worry, I will show you how to install just an XCI file and an NSP file on their own. So I'm going to plug in my game cartridge. There's Crash Bandicoot Insane Trilogy. So just to show, we'll run it and show that it works here. So there we go, game is running from my game cartridge. So that's loading up, and I'll just close the software. And if I take the game cartridge out and then try and run it, you'll see it says insert game card. So I cannot run it without the game cartridge being inserted. So I'll insert the game card again. And now we're going to dump this to an XCI file, which is just a game dump of the entire game into one file, essentially. So what we're going to do is we're going to go into Album on our Homebrew, our free custom firmware. We're going to run the Homebrew App Store because there's a certain application we need to download that will allow us to dump our game cartridge. So I'm going to go down to Tools, and then scroll down till I find the application that I'm after. There you go, GC Dump Tool, Nintendo Switch Game Card Dump Tool. So we're gonna select this and we're gonna download it to our SD card. Basically does everything for you, so it's really, really useful. So we're gonna go back to the home screen, then we're gonna go back to Album again, and now we have GC Dump Tool available. So we're gonna select this, and then it says Nintendo Switch Game Card Dump Tool. And then it's going to ask what kind of dump we want to do. So we're going to do a full XCI dump. Okay, so there's a few additional options in here you need to check. So split output dump FAT32 support. You only want to enable this if your SD card is formatted in FAT32 format. Now mine's XFAT format, so I don't have to worry about that. But basically, FAT32 formatted devices can't have any files on them that are larger than 4 GB. So this will split the game up into multiple parts that are less than 4 GB. That way it will fit on your SD card. Now mine's XFAT format, so I can have files larger than 4 GB, so I don't have to enable this. But if you do have a FAT32 formatted SD card, then you're going to want to change that to yes using the D-pad on the left Joy-Con. So yeah, that's basically it. Now, if you don't know if your SD card is in FAT32 format or XFAT format, just plug it into your computer, right-click on the SD card in the Windows File Explorer, and go to Properties, and then it'll say File System, and it'll tell you there if it's in FAT32 or XFAT format. So for me, I'm on XFAT, so I don't have to enable that, but if you're on FAT32, you want to enable that. So then there's this option down here called Trim Output Dump. So I recommend turning this on. This basically just removes some extra data in the dumped file that's not really required, so it saves a bit more space on your SD card. So we'll do that, and then we will start the XCI dump process. And there you go, it starts dumping the entire game to your SD card. Now, of course, depending on the size of the game, this could take a very long time, or if it's a small game, it may only take, you know, a minute or so. So just wait for this progress bar to hit 100%, and then we can move on with the rest of the tutorial. Okay, so here you go. As you can see, it says the process successfully completed. Press any button to continue, that'll take us out, and then I guess I just keep pressing B until... Oh no, plus to exit. Okay, press plus button and then we exit. Okay, so there we go. So now we need to actually install it so that we can run it, because all we've done is we've taken a dump of the game, and that is now a file. A dump file of the game is now on our SD card, but we need to install it. So we need a certain piece of homebrew for that, tinfoil. You can also use gold leaf as well, but I've had numerous problems trying to get that to work. Many times with various different things, so tinfoil seems to be the easier way to get things working. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to switch off the switch, take the SD card out, and hook it up to our computer. Okay, so going over to the computer here, I've got my SD card connected, and as you can see, we have our game dump right here, the Crash Bandicoot Insane Trilogy XCI file. So that is the dumped game. So what we're going to do is I'm going to make a new folder just called games, and I'm going to put it in there. So I'm going to cut and paste it into my games folder. You can just put it in any folder you want, it doesn't really matter. But the program we're going to use to install it is called Tinfoil, and you can go ahead and download this from tinfoil.io. Link will be in the description. Just download the latest version. There's also Lithium, which you can use as well, which is like a simplified version, but Tinfoil is easy enough to use, so we don't really need Lithium. So we'll download Tinfoil. As you can see, I've got the latest version right here. So I'm going to open up the zip file, and we install it quite simply by putting it in the switch folder. So we go into the switch folder on the zip file, we go into the switch folder on the SD card, and copy the tinfoil folder into the switch folder on the SD card, and then refresh, and that's it installed. It'll show up in your homebrew menu when you next go on the switch. So the game is an XCI file, as I've already mentioned, but there are also games that come in NSP files. So I've got Shovel Knight here, which is an NSP file, and an update for Shovel Knight as well, which is also an NSP file. So just to show you how to install those, I'm going to copy them on to the games folder on the SD card. And if you have any other NSP files on your computer, or any XCI files, then you can just copy them to your SD card and we can install them with tinfoil. So now that we have tinfoil installed and we've got our games on there, we can go ahead and unplug our SD card, plug it back into the switch. So also remember that you need to have the SIG patches installed in the atmosphere folder. So you need these EXEFS patches folder, and in the kit patches, you need the FS patches folder. You also need to be injecting the Fuse primary payload to boot into atmosphere, not Hiketa. If you use the Hiketa payload to boot into atmosphere, or you don't have the SIG patches installed, then you are going to run into issues where you try and install a game in tinfoil and it will give you an error message, or it will install successfully, but when you try and run the game, you'll get an error message saying that the game is corrupted. So you need to have those SIG patches installed, and you need to be booting atmosphere using the Fuse primary payload. That's all covered in episode 1. Again, the playlist link is in the description, so rewatch episode 1 if you need to. Okay, so back onto the Switch now. As you can see, I've still got Crash Bandicoot on here, but it will not launch because it tells me to insert the game card. I noticed I kept calling it cartridge before for whatever reason, I guess force of habit, but game card is what I meant. So we can delete this now because we're going to install the dumped version, so we no longer need this one on here. So we'll get rid of that. Then we'll go into the album, launching our homebrew menu, and we'll now have tinfoil available to launch. There we go, we'll get this error, just click OK. Not sure why that error appears, but it doesn't seem to affect anything that I've really noticed, so things should still work. So we go into the file browser, then we go down to SDMC, which is our SD card, and then look for your XCI or NSP files, so mine are in my games folder, and then we can install it. So I'm going to select Crash Bandicoot Insane Trilogy, our XCI file. Now you have a few options in here. Install all DLC and install latest update. That doesn't actually download from the internet. That would be great if it did. But that's actually only if you have other NSP files, like separate game updates as separate NSP files, then it will install those automatically for you. if you have any on your SD card. If not, then just say no. And the location is where it's going to install to, so you can either install the games to your SD card or you can install them to the NAND, which is the internal flash memory of the device. So I'm going to install it to the SD card and then select A for install, and it starts installing the game. So now you just have to wait for this bar to get to the end and your game will be installed. Now you can also install games using a program called Goldleaf, which actually comes with Cosmos, but it doesn't allow you to install XCI files, at least not directly from the SD card. You have to kind of inject it over the USB cable from your computer, and you have to install Python and install a bunch of other programs to get it up and running. So I just found that this is, you know, the easier method, really. I mean, if you can get everything set up correctly to use Goldleaf, then it might be quicker to install in the long run. But in terms of ease of use for beginners, tinfoil definitely takes the cake. So the window will close when it's complete, and that's it installed. Now, NSP files install in the exact same way. So I can install Shovel Knight just by selecting A on it, again, selecting a location and selecting install, and it will install the game. Of course, this is a very, very small game, so it only takes a few seconds. And there we go. So to exit, you just keep pressing B until you get this message and then click OK. And then we can go to the home menu. And there we go, our games now show up. And you notice the Crash Bandicoot no longer has the little game card symbol because you don't need the game card inserted to run it. So if we try and run it, you'll see that it works. No problem. The game runs just as it did when I had the game card inserted, but I do not have the game card inserted anymore. And the game is running absolutely fine, no issues there. So, okay, so let's just close out of this and try and run Shovel Knight. And here we go. Now we're running into an issue. So it won't let me run the game without a software update. And that becomes a bit of a problem because we can't really do a software update, because even if I try and do one, it's not going to work because we installed the 90DNS, which blocks all the connections to Nintendo servers, so we can't download updates from Nintendo servers. So this is where this becomes a bit of a problem. So now what you can do, of course, is you can, you know, reflash your backed up NAND back onto the system, boot back into original firmware, remove 90DNS, and then do the update for the game, although that's still not really recommended. Or you could not do that, and you could just clear your error logs from Atmosphere and then hop on original firmware and then remove 90DNS, do the update, add the DNS server back in as soon as you've done the update. Again, these all run risks of you getting banned. So if you definitely don't want to get banned, then the best thing to do is to get the update as an NSP file and install it with tinfoil, which I, as you probably noticed before, I had two Shovel Knight files that I copied over to my SD card. One of them was the actual game, the other one was an update for the game. So if I go down to SDMC, I go down to games, I've got the Shovel Knight update NSP file that I can install. And then if I do that, you'll see that if I go back now after installing it, when I try and run the game, there you go, it runs without any issue. So yeah, that's the safest way to update your games as an NSP file. You install the game as an NSP file, and then you also get an NSP file for the update and install that, and then you'll be able to run your NSP file games. So I'm not gonna lie, it's a bit difficult sometimes to find the update NSP files online, and I can't tell you where to go to find them because Nintendo will probably claim the video or take it down via DMCA takedown because they're hypersensitive to anything. So I can't really tell you where to go, you know, what specific website to go to download the game updates. But I can give you hopefully something that will help in your search to find the updates. So if we head back onto Tinfoil and we go down to tickets and then we look at our game right here. So as you can see, it gives me the name of the game and the title ID. So you can see for Shovel Knight, we've got 01057D0021E8000. That is the title ID of the game. Now, the update for a game is the same as the title ID for the game, but one digit is different. So you can see the one underneath that doesn't have a name, that's the update for the game. It's got the same title ID as Shovel Knight, except right at the end, the third digit in from the right is 8, instead of a 0. So right here it ends 8000 and this one ends 8800. It's the same for Super Mario Party. Even though I don't have that installed, it still shows up in tinfoil for some reason. But you can see that the one for Super Mario Party is 4000 and then the update file is 4800. So all the update files have that third digit in from the right changed to an 8. So if you are searching on Google for, you know, a game update as an NSP file, then find what the title ID of the game is in tinfoil. So then type that title ID into Google and change the third digit in from the right to an 8. So instead of 000, it's 800 at the end, and search for that and you'll have a much better chance of finding the update file that way. Unfortunately, that's all the help I can really give you in that regard. So yeah, that is how you install games on the Nintendo Switch on free custom firmware, and how to dump your game cards to the SD card so you can run them from the SD card without the game card being inserted, and how to get updates and install NSP and XCI files, all covered in this video. So the playlist link will be in the description to the previous episode, and check out the next episode, which will be coming out in a few days, which is going to be about how to install emulators so you can run all your favorite games all the way from, you know, way back to the original Sega Master System and original NES, all the way through to PlayStation 1 games and GameCube games and Nintendo 64 games. You can run all those games from all those different systems from, you know, the early 80s to the early 2000s, all on your Nintendo Switch, which is pretty awesome. So that's going to be covered in the next episode. So thank you guys for watching. If you liked the video or found the information useful, please leave a like and subscribe, and I'll hopefully see you guys in the next episode.